Hey, I'm Two-Toed Miles, and I've been working hard on a special project here, and I'm doing whatever I can to promote it. See, I love Halloween. I love carving pumpkins, and I love ska music. And I'm willing to put my money where my mouth is and bet that there are people out there who feel the same way. So in that spirit, I've put together a ska-themed pumpkin carving contest. How do I enter, you may ask? It's real simple. Just send me a photo of your own ska-themed pumpkin carving to skonbiology@gmail.com. Again, that's skonbiology@gmail.com. Now, I'll be hosting photos of the entries on my website, skonbiology.wordpress.com, so be sure to stop in and check out the competition. So yeah, real simple instructions. Email a photo to skonbiology@gmail.com, give it a clever caption if you're up to it, just make sure you get your submission in by October 25th. Why so early? Two reasons. Number one, I'm trying to announce the winners on Halloween. Number two, I want to get the official ballots in the hands of the special guest judges with plenty of time to make their decision before Halloween. Now, who are these guest judges? Let's just say I've put together quite the panel. You've got Robert Bucket Hingley of the Toasters. And seems like that guy's always on tour, manning the merch booth before shows. Just an incredible work ethic. Being so busy, I hate to give him yet another thing to do, but I'm incredibly honored that he said yes. We have Less Than Jake. Now, Losing Streak was the first ska album I ever owned, and it's just so cool to be working with them. And finally, we have Greg Proops, who you may remember from Whose Line Is It Anyway, and whose Proop casts are not to be missed. It's been a real honor to be collaborating with such a fine panel on this contest. Some people have come up to me and say, you know, Greg Proops, how do you manage that one? Having listened to Greg's Proop casts, guy really knows his music, and I kind of had him pegged as a bit of a ska fan, and turns out I was right. So, what are you playing for? Well, the first prize gets a $50 iTunes gift card. Pretty good for carving a pumpkin. You'll also be getting a satin handset for that special rude girl in your life. And if that seems a bit random to you, I will concede that point. I'll give you that point. But I know the sales lady, and she can definitely hang. She may not be ska for life like yours truly, but she can hang. So it's a pretty cool freebie to be given away. Second place is a $25 gift card, and third is a $15 gift card. I'll also be printing up a special certificate for those winners. But is that all there is to win? Not even close. See, I've got a lot of bands who said they'd kick in merchandise. Bands like The Sentiments, The Georgetown Orbits, Necktie Killer, The Original Middle Age Ska and Joy Club, The Big Takeover, Class Action, Fairhaven, The Delirians, ska bands like us, 4.0, Two-Tone Lizard Kings. I'm still working every day to get even more prizes. I think Rude King might be joining the festivities. Both the Long Johns and Half Past Two, they're working on new music, and they indicated that they might be available to kick in their as-of-yet-unreleased tracks. So this may be your chance to get your hands on some completely new stuff. Since this is Halloween, I'm super pleased to announce that Rude Zombie will be putting in one of the prizes. Seems like a perfect fit, Halloween and Rude Zombie. And I'm still in talks with Civilized Animal to put something together with them. Civilized Animal, I caught them damn near a decade ago in Walla Walla with the wife who was at the time just my girlfriend. So we're still together, and nice to see Civilized Animal still kicking it, still putting out awesome music. If I've left anyone out here, I do apologize. It's just a lot of prizes to keep track of from a lot of amazing bands. So there's going to be a lot of cool stuff to win, and I hope this encourages you to join. And if you're with a ska band and thinking, yeah, we want to kick in something too, something for a prize, you know, hit me up with an email. The more the merrier, really. Giving away the band merch, we're going to be doing that a little different. Not so much going to the judges' cards for that. I didn't want to have one winner take home the lion's share of the loot. Nor did I want to impose any sort of judgment of merit by putting certain bands ahead of others on the prize tier. And honestly, this seemed like a cool opportunity to give people some new music that they might not be listening to. So we're gonna give the band merch away by raffle, by drawing. So your submission automatically enters you into the drawing to win some awesome band merch. And if you take home one of the top three prizes, you're automatically getting some band merch too. I've been getting some additional questions about the rules. Can I carve something other than a pumpkin? Yeah, sure, why not? Sounds a little difficult, but if you want to do it, do it. Does it have to be ska-related? Well, not necessarily. If you got a sweet Bob Marley pumpkin in mind, by all means carve it, I'd love to see it. Just keep in mind the overall spirit of the competition, and the fact that it's being guest judged. But if it's in keeping with the spirit of the competition, all submissions are welcome. If you're looking for some designs, here are a couple that I might suggest. So yeah, I'm really excited to be putting this all together, and to be working with so many amazing people. I've had a lot of these bands let me use their music in the past, and I thank you just so much for your support. You guys make this a hell of a lot of fun. To my guest judges, I realize your time is valuable, and I'm truly humbled to be worthy of your time. I think this is going to be a lot of fun. I look forward to seeing your submissions. Potato Cat agrees with me. Potato. I'm Two-Tone Miles. Happy Ska-Lloween, everybody.